Oh, good shooting, buddy.
Thanks. Good stuff, mate. Now you can go to bed.
A clear and restful night, broken with the occasional light rain shower, gives way to a beautiful morning, albeit a little foggy. After 2 days stuck in camp due to some pretty grim weather, we're up and out early this morning, eager to take advantage of the bright conditions. First up is our favourite vantage point at the bottom of the airstrip, from which we've seen plenty of game. However, the wind's not in our favour today, blowing down the ridge towards the animals we were glassing yesterday. The moose and bear we spotted previously are no longer visible, and with the wind now at our backs, we need to reassess the situation. So we head back to camp for breakfast and to consider our next move.
Boo! Morning, September the 2nd. My wedding anniversary, so happy anniversary, Suze. We've not managed to kill anything yet, but the weather's not looking bad this morning. Fog's just lifted, rain's lifted, so we're going to try and get some moose down. We saw them in the valley last night, they've come back in. They weren't in yesterday at all, so that's good. As you can see, everything is looking a bit brighter. There's a bit of sun over there, so it's all good. And Tony's up, he's out his tent. There's our tent, there's Mark. Give us a wave, Mark. Whee! So there we go. All is good. Hopefully get them done. See you in a bit.
Whilst we love the view from camp and have seen plenty of game, the consensus is we'd like to explore some new ground, but without disturbing the game-rich environment in the valley below. Our best bet is to try and circumvent the wind by hiking back up the trail we created on day 3, over the ridge and out onto the far plateau above. Here, there are sure to be fresh berry patches and the chance of a grizzly bear. Despite the fact we've already cut a trail, the going is still tough, and there are always plenty of wet alders and willow clawing at your feet in clothes. We set up on the plateau, scanning the berry patches clinging to the sheer face of a box canyon. Within minutes, we've spotted not one, but two grizzly bears feeding on different berry patches. The power of these animals is truly incredible as we watch in awe as one of the grizzlies takes a little under 5 minutes to climb a rock face that would have taken us mere mortals several hours. We see an opportunity to head him off at the pass and formulate a cunning plan.
So up on the slope, we've seen two grizzly bear, one high up in the mountain and another one that's just come crawled up from the valley below us and is feeding on some berries. Now they're a bit high for us to make a stalk into them, so we're going to head over. There's a drainage there that's sheltered from the wind. And we're going to see if these bear come back down. Once they finish feeding on one spot, they're going to come down the mountain, go over a ravine, and then go back up and feed on the berries at the top. So this is a waiting game. It's all about patience, but so far it looks pretty good. Could have the choice of two bear.
While this sounds like a great plan, the reality of the task ahead of us is a little more challenging. River crossings are a constant obstacle, as are the continuously rolling ridges. Whilst we're at the top, we take the opportunity to glass over our favourite Moose Valley. It's also a welcome chance to catch our breath, grab a snack, and recharge our batteries after the morning's exertions. This very familiar area looks entirely different from this angle in elevation, opening up the deep cuts and crevasses in the landscape to our view. It's easy to see how huge animals such as a moose can seem to disappear in the blink of an eye, such is the vastness of this landscape. But this area is not our focus today, and we climb back up onto the plateau and resume our pursuit of the grizzly bear. Much to our surprise, the bear has covered a lot of ground and appears to be heading directly towards us.
He's a dark one from earlier. He's digging something out.
The bear has stopped on the way for a quick snack, digging out an unfortunate ground squirrel from its burrow.
To the top of that flat there.
It's certainly much closer than we expected, yeah. And we get our heads together to discuss the options.
You guys have got good shooting sticks.
Yeah.
You'll be able to shoot over to the top of that.
We need to move and try and keep pace with this powerful predator.
It's going to take us forever to get down there.
With the wind in our favour, this represents a golden opportunity. But the bear is moving quickly and we need to be decisive. Steve is in the chair and readies his rifle for action, adjusting the turrets of his Hawke Frontier 5-30x50. With the speed the bear is moving, it's unlikely there will be time to make adjustments on the fly. We're now very close, but have lost sight of the bear. Worse still, we're out in the open. We must cross the riverbed and make for the cover of the ridge beyond. Steve is already set and ready to go, so he keeps a lookout whilst I load and prepare my rifle ready for the backup shot. We're expecting a close encounter, so we're not leaving anything to chance. Steve takes his eyes off the horizon for a few moments to check on progress, but it's just enough to allow the bear to outflank us. Unbelievably, this massive boar has managed to evade three pairs of eyes and spots us before we have time to react, taking flight back up to the safety of the mountain.
So that was pretty exciting. We've seen a lot of bear today. Just been glassing around the ridge back towards camp, came behind the ridge out of the wind to have a look back on some of the ground that we covered earlier on. And lo and behold, there's a grizzly making its way down the hillside behind us. We glassed him as he dug up a ground squirrel and had a bit of lunch on the way down. But he was heading straight in our direction. So as he disappeared into a ditch, we made the decision to cross the ravine behind us, come back up here, get ready, and then ambush him on his way down to the valley below. Unfortunately, he got there a bit quicker than we were expecting. Our grizzly pops up above the horizon, spots us all, and then heads for the hills behind us. So, pretty close.
Very close.
Yeah.
Like 80 yards close.
Yeah. I think had we been a little bit quicker and him have been a little bit more relaxed on his way down, then that would have been a 40-yard shot, maybe even 30. But as it happens, he's now back at the top of the mountain and away.
Walk 10.
Yeah. But exciting times, eh?
Sorry?
Exciting.
Very exciting. Better luck next time.
There's always tomorrow. But it's great to see so many bear. Great to see one come so close. A bit disappointing when you see the back end of it running away from you, but as I say, that's hunting, and I'm sure there'll be many more opportunities. So,
never mind, mate. Let's get at it and get back to camp.
Yeah, let's get back.
Disappointed but philosophical, we make our way back to camp after a tough but rewarding day. After the monumental trek back up across the plateau and our close encounter with the grizzly bear, we have a surprise visitor right next to camp. I quickly grab my sticks and get into position to take the shot. It's a younger black bear, but I'm not concerned by trophy size. We're here to harvest animals, and this is an unexpected opportunity not to be passed up. The bear moves behind cover, and I must reposition for a clear shot. Rock steady on the sticks, I load and wait for the right shot to present itself. He finally turns and the 225 grain Hornady Superformance SST does its job perfectly.
And we finally got a bear on the ground.
We have.
But it wasn't one that we were looking for. We've seen three different brown bear today. In fact, as you saw, we got really close to one, but he busted us. Maybe he was too fast, we were too slow, whatever it was. Came back into camp, had dinner and a coffee, just about to go to bed. And then just off the ridge behind us here, a black bear came out. Steve was already in bed. We had to get him up, we had to wake him up. But this is the thing now, this is big country and animals can jump up at any time. And you can see nothing all day and then all of a sudden it happens all at once. So 212 yards, really happy with the shot. So I'm gonna leave him out there tonight and wait until it gets light, go in the morning, skin him out and then see what we have there. But other than that, really good day. It's been a fantastic stalk. It's been an incredible day, seen a lot of game. What an amazing finish to a pretty epic day.
Appreciate it.
Thanks.
Now you can go back to bed.
Now you can go to bed.